Hey everyone, Selina here on this latest episode of Selina Thomas, SCV HR Guru, where I bring the stories of the people in our community to you. I am so excited to do a quick recap of some of my former guests, and then of course, of the headlines. Magic Mountain, as of today, is open. We're so excited to be bringing back jobs and making memories. That was a great interview with our Assemblywoman, Suzette Valadares, and Nick Burkhart from Magic Mountain. Everything they said in that interview came true, and we're here. This community is recovering, and you can see it in all the activities that are happening. Also, Marty Ross had his first in-person show, and of course, an interview with the Australian equivalent to Good Morning Australia. I have a little snippet of that. He did great, and of course, all good things for him coming up. This episode is about the resurgence of skating in our community. There is a roller skating group that has basically introduced this to a new generation, and now Central Park has become the buzz. Every week there are more skaters, and of course, a new group of skaters has developed a love for what we did in our childhood. I hope you enjoy this episode. I hope you're getting out and enjoying and continuing to stay safe. We'll see you next time. And I am so excited to talk to you guys today. I had a great opportunity to come out and see you at Central Park last week. And the amount of people and the range of type of people was so exciting. And I really wanted to have some time in a quiet space because the music was bumping. I wanted to make sure I gave you an opportunity to speak to the community about what you're doing out there. Tell us about your skating group, and then, of course, first about you. So, Casey.
Okay. Well, my name is Casey, and I am a part of the Santa Clarita community. I have been here for several years. So, since 2004 is when I first moved out here from LA, and I've always been a skater, roller skater, since I've been a little girl, and it's something that I do. I'm very passionate about skating, the outdoors, the wind in my hair, all of that. It is very freeing. Yes. Woo! Yeah.
And you brought the community together, and that was what was so impressive, was that you brought so many people together to enjoy a passion that you have, that you've had since a child. And that's like reverberated through all the interviews that I had, was that people dusted off their skates, their clothes from that era, and they really got into it. And
I could fit the clothes. I can't fit the clothes. But my girl here, she shows off her cutest outfits, her bell bottoms. Did you see her bell bottoms?
I'm gonna feature that at the end of this. But it was so great to see that you've introduced it to another generation. Tell me about what that's been like for you.
Oh my gosh. It's just been amazing. It's like my childhood coming back. All this nostalgia is just flooding all at once. I just absolutely love it. I grew up in San Diego, and moved here actually in Santa Clarita in 2000 after my daughter was born. And back in the day, I used to skate all the time. I mean, just all the time. And then I grew out of my favorite skates, and that was it. And that was when I was about 14 years old, and I really hadn't roller skated since I was 14. And so I know that when you and I are, Casey and I were talking back in the summer, we were just like, she said she had got her some roller skates, and I was like, oh my gosh, I want roller skates. And it just, from there.
Yeah. So you pulled out more than a roller skates. You pulled out your whole ensemble and then some, and the energy. Yes. That's what was palpable, was the energy. And it is the different types of people that said the same thing, that, you know, I was roller skating in the pandemic in my cul-de-sac until I heard about this group. So tell me how you put it out there. And the fact is that it's growing every week. Now you have an additional day. Tell me about that.
Yes. Well, okay. We started on Saturday evenings because we are also a part of the group, the Skating Mamas of SCV. And as the Black Love Skate Crew,
we said we wanted to do something at nighttime and do something a little different, you know, bring the community together, but more of an adult type of vibe and get a little funky at night with the roller skate dancing. So that's what we decided. We were saying, let's have a daytime thing for the families and let's have a nighttime thing for the grownups.
Drama closed, that's the only thing you can do right now. Even though we're starting to come out of this pandemic, it's still not safe to be in indoor events without kind of going through a whole protocol. And you're not kind of an organization that can create testing and
clear
people. So it was easier to do it outside.
Yes, right? Easier.
And then
it's fun.
April, perfect weather.
Exactly. The lights are up and it's a wonderful environment outdoors and people are having fun and you're so free and there's the distancing. There's no better place right now.
So much fun. Yes.
That the basketball players allowed you guys to kind of have your space. And I know they can be territorial, especially with March Madness. Everyone's inspired to play basketball right now. But they were enjoying kind of letting you guys at a distance do your thing. And I had a gentleman tell me that.
Yeah, they've been very nice.
I want to get my skates.
Exactly. And they want to go home and get their skates and come back. And they love the music, too. So
I see them, bumping their head over there. Yeah.
So I want to talk a little bit about the music because that does create the pulse for, when you go to a roller rink, that's kind of, there's slow skate and then there's boogie skate. And then there's, so tell me about that because you guys look like you had something for everyone.
Well, we usually started with a more old school, that old double Dutch bus and more bounce to the ounce and bounce roll skate kind of music, 1970, and we'll even go back as far as James Brown. Sometimes we gotta put him in there, and other old school. So, it's a mix of everything. Then we roll it a little more modern to the 80s, and then we roll it on to the 90s, and we just keep rolling until we get to our modern today. With some Justin Timberlake, and we get a lot of different sounds in there.
And it sounds like you get a lot of requests. I think I saw the DJ kind of fielding requests from people like, do you have this? Do you have that? And so that was really great that he was out there.
He accepts requests sometimes, but we also use what's called our bump box. And that, that's a whole nother level.
Talk about, because when I talked to your DJ, he volunteered to do this. He said it was a great event and he felt that, separate from his day job, that he wanted to give something back. And when I see events like this, I'm always impressed that it kind of spreads people giving and that energy of people wanting to be, in a community. And that by itself is a huge reason why I wanted to make sure that we did a story on you and featured that. Because with the summer coming, we still have to be careful and to give people a place to go and something new to do. I'm happy to share that.
We appreciate you so much, Selina. And we know that there's more things to come, more surprises. So I will keep you posted.
Absolutely.
A little bit about you being socially aware. I thought that was so important. I saw some Black love. I saw that you were out there kind of with a social message. So tell me a little bit about that.
Well, are you familiar with the Black skating, the history of the Black people that skated in the civil rights movement and things like that back in the day? It's a good story. It's United Skates. If anyone gets a chance to watch that, they really should. It tells you so much about our history and why roller skating is so important to our culture. Yes. It's something that we did. And I still do, as I mentioned, this is a freeing experience for me. So
so many people about our culture and about the where it originated, but in a positive way. Because I know that in social messaging, sometimes we can lose the positive part of just being out there together. And I wanted to make sure that people could see that there's a positive way to bring social issues and messages to people.
Exactly.
Yes.
We are called Black Love Skate Crew, but we are, you know, Black Love. We are people of color. We are diversified in every way. So we are welcoming everyone to come and skate with us. And just the music will tell you what we're about.
Yes.
I know you talked a little bit, and I want you to be able to share this, about eventually, as this grows, fundraising and providing a platform or using your platform to raise not just awareness, but money. Tell me a little bit about that.
Well, I'm going to let Celeste talk about that because we're still, you know, we're at such a beginning where the money is kind of way back there. We're not really thinking about that as much. We'd love to have sponsorships. We'd love to have fundraisers. We are planning on doing some, but right now we're still just enjoying the skating part. The fundraisers, I can tell you. Well, do you want to? You want to go? Okay,
she's doing a good job.
Let us know so that we can post okay. that, because I know that when people have an opportunity to lend to something that's positive, they want to do it. They just need to know that it's out there.
Exactly.
So when you have more details about it, I'm happy to share it. I thank you. Well, so much for sharing that you guys are doing this every week. I have some footage for the show that I'll be sharing after this interview so that people can really understand the magnitude of what you created here. And it's something that you should be really proud of.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
We're very proud. But I will get with you and let you know. I can give you our, we have a Facebook page, which is Black Love Skate Crew. And we also have
episode.
Huh?
I'll post it all at the end of this episode.
Okay. And you can also reach us at blacklovemedia1@gmail.com. And, you know, we're open for opportunities.
We also have an Instagram page. Yes, Black Love Skate Group. Mm-hmm. And feel free to check us out there as well. Everything's getting started. So just, you know, hang in there.
Yeah.
I love the positive energy. I can't wait for people to see this episode. And I thank you both for sharing your time and of your course. Positive messages in this way. And I will be getting like all my equipment together so that I can ultimately skate safely. But
yay!
I'm definitely inspired by both of you. So thank you again.
Thank you. Wonderful.
Take
thank
care.
You so much.
We'll talk to you.
Back here with Cheryl Stabler.
Hi, Cheryl. Nice to meet you. It's so nice to see so many people out here. Tell me why you come and how did you find out about it?
I come to get exercise and because our rink in North Ridge closed down. So I would go every Sunday night. When it closed, we were all without a place to sit. And so when I saw that they were going to have outdoor skating, it was a no-brainer. I was in.
How excited. So how many years have you been skating? Because I've watched you for a little while and I'm so impressed.
Oh, I'm from the Midwest, so I grew up skating since I was maybe 5, 6 years
old. So it's like walking for you.
Yeah.
And I love your skates. Can we get a shot of those skates? Those are amazing. So a chance to get out, get with people that you are like-minded with, and then of course we see new people out here.
Right.
So you're helping people kind of learn the whole process. So tell me about that.
Yeah, well, what I really love is seeing all the little babies out, you know, and start, it reminds me of my youth coming out on Saturdays, well, at the rink and skating with the big kids and just having fun, you know, and so the most genuine thing about being here is seeing our community come together as sisters. No matter what color we are, we all are having fun together.
Sorry, you're competing with me.
Friday, Saturday at the roller rink, but it's been a while, and honestly, I was just looking for something fun to do outdoors that I can see my kids.
Sure,
run the park. I leave them at home. I don't even bring them here. Yeah, and then when I found, you know, Casey and her group, it was just made to be. Yeah.
I love to see how the basketball has allowed you guys to kind of share space.
Yeah.
And through the whole pandemic, I've seen them out here, but this is another, like, half of the court that they have. said, you know what, you guys do your thing. Yeah. That's really nice that you guys are sharing.
I grew up in Queens, and you just have to fight for a basketball.
I would imagine.
So I've been surprised that, like, it's been as easy and as cordial.
Yeah. Well, I think everyone is so happy to see people out.
Yeah.
And so we continue to come. I know we've added more days. And how has just maybe been coming back for you? Is it like riding the bike?
Yes and no. I definitely wear a lot more protection than I used to. But yeah, I try to come out twice a week. And then working with Casey, just kind of get the word out so that folks know about it. Because that's the biggest thing is once people know about it, they want to be involved.
And have you, since you've been coming, seen more and more skaters every week?
I have. Growing. Yeah. Oh, yeah, for sure. And, like, I have a friend of mine. I recruited her to come today.
There you go.
Because I sent her a video, and I was like, there's a DJ. There's tons of people. Like, it feels like normal life again.
That's
so
wonderful.
Yeah, so she brought a pair of skates, and I think it's really popular. It was hard for me to find skates. A lot of places are sold out.
Really?
And when I found my pair, I went to pick them up, and
it must have been like Christmas.
Well, the man at the shop, I kind of made a joke, like, oh, I'm the mom here to pick up her roller skates. And he said, that's all who's buying roller skates.
I love
He's
that.
Like, it's all adult
Skate
women.
Mamas.
He's
there
like,
you
it's
go.
All adult women buying
So skates. He was not surprised to see you.
No, he was like, yeah. He's like, of course, it's all mom. Mine.
And then here's the safety of your mom.
Yeah, I was like, I need a helmet. I need
Right, exactly. Well, I saw people just taking the time. I'm going to get some footage of you skating and getting back into it. And I'm so excited that we are the
community. Oh my God, I love this. Someone invited me on Facebook, and I have been skating before the pandemic every Sunday night, Thursday night, and Skateland closed. That was like my home. And so I skated all the time, and when it closed, I was just lonely during the pandemic. And I got new skates that didn't come in until. Yes! And they didn't come in until. They came in March of last year when the pandemic started.
So
all the skating rinks. So they sat in a box, and I was so sad, and I used to just. In my cul-de-sac by myself, and then this
no
happened.
Music.
No music, and then someone invited me on Facebook, and this was they invited me to Skate Mamas first,
okay.
And then this started, which is more like what I'm used to, the music I'm used to, the culture I'm used to. So I loved it.
And the camaraderie of skaters, you found a whole community that's just
yes.
like you. That must be killer.
It is. I had that family. I mean, to me, it's like skate family. I had it at Northridge Skateland, and we just disappeared, but it's brought up here. And then tonight, the manager from Skateland was up here, and like three other skaters. So it was great. It was like family reunion.
Yeah.
And new people.
Oh, every
I skated my whole life till I had kids, and then I raised my kids. They're off at college, and I got my skates. I got started skating like 3 years ago, and it's just like I'm back to
You're
myself again.
Right. I love that. Well, thank you for taking the time to talk to us. I'm so glad that you found a place with your tribe to be able to do this and continue to come out. It's got to be great to be. We have more light now, so you can skate longer. How often do you skate up there?
I skate every Saturday, and I try to make it to as many events when I don't have to be working. I told my husband I wanted to put one.
Honestly, I feel like I'm a beginner compared to some of these amazing skaters out here.
Sure.
But we've been skating since we were 9 years old. We kind of just grew with the skater rink. We go every Friday, Saturday night.
How fun.
Yeah.
Way to get out and get some exercise, too.
And I stopped for years, up to about 2 weeks ago.
Yeah. And now you're out with your daughter.
Yeah,
how
my daughter's
fun.
Daughter.
Nice. Well, I love your skates. Can we get a shot of the skates? You definitely don't look like novice. It stopped
Thank
me
you.
To pay attention to your skates. So
it's fun. When I found out that you burn 1,000 calories with 60 minutes of skating consistently,
no
I was in.
Yes, definitely. Well, I'm so glad you guys came out and that we have longer days now with the time changing, and I'll definitely look forward to seeing you guys some more.
Yeah.
Thank you again.
Enjoy
Thank you
so much.
Yes,
Thank you.
Hey everybody, Selina back out here at Central Park. I'm talking to
Rosé.
Nice to meet you. I saw you getting set up, ready to go. I love your skates. I love the whole ensemble. And obviously, there's a resurgence of skating in Santa Clarita. And you've been a skater. So tell me how you found out about it and why you're here.
I found out about it on Facebook. So I thought it was the greatest thing during the pandemic and the quarantine. I just wanted to get out. I wanted to skate. Because I'm an old school skater.
Okay.
From way back in the day as a kid growing up in roller skates. So I love it. When I got the invite, I was like, perfect. Oh my God, I'm going to be there. It's outside. I can skate.
Yes. And it's safe. And I can't wait to get some footage of you skating. Because you said you're old school. Combined with the music, I'm expecting great things.
Oh, well, yes. Now, I don't know about that. I'm old now.
But you're out here. That's
I'm
what's
out
so
here,
great.
And it's just exercise. That's great.
And your family is here.
Yes. I have my daughters, both of my daughters, and my grandson.
Really?
And my sister's here. My brother-in-law is
That's
here.
That's exciting. Your whole family.
Yes. My godbrother is here. And okay.
Wanted to know your name.
My name is Mike. Mike Duryea.
Nice to meet you, Mike. We talked a little bit earlier about the fact that this was an event that you actually volunteered to DJ because it was such a great event. Tell me about this.
I saw on Facebook the Facebook page that they had, and I've seen the videos and pictures of like that. So it seemed like a fun group. I've DJed off and on since 1987, and I've been doing it as a side gig the last 10 years. And last year, because of COVID, I only had 5 gigs last year at all last year. So I figured I'd volunteer, come in for a couple hours on a Saturday, meet some cool people, get invited to the cool kid party, and play some music and have a good time. So, and it worked out.
What a great event to volunteer. Hey, everybody, I am back here with
McKinley,
nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
I saw you skating and I was really impressed with your abilities. I noticed you have rollerblades on.
Yeah.
Nice. So is this something that you've been doing for a long time?
I've been doing this for 12 years.
12 years?
Been rollerblading for 12 years. I stopped for about 8. Okay. And 3 years ago, I picked it up again. I couldn't skate for anything. I was trying to get out the door, I'd fall. So
really?
Within 3 years, I've gotten to the point where I am now. And that's just because I skate for fun. I have always skated for fun. And it's just one of my favorite hobbies to do.
Great. So you found out about this out here?
I found out about this through an Instagram ad.
Instagram?
Yeah.
Okay. Everyone's finding out different ways. It's growing every weekend.
Yeah.
So what are you sensing when you come out every time you come?
I'm sensing a really big community that really shows how much we need like a roller rink out here.
Yeah.
I've heard rumors that there might make one down when they open Mount Asia.
Sure.
I always loved going to the ice skating rink as well. I can't wait to go back when they open that again.
Yes, the cube is coming soon.
Y'all should have been here the first time I was out here with my sister because my sister's in a wheelchair. I was out here, I would be skating out here with her. I always will with her whenever she's here. I used
nice.
To do it on ice as well.
What a nice way, like you said, for the community to come back together and to do something that is great for your body and your mind. And so you'll continue to come. Tell me what you're looking forward to.
I'm looking forward to this community growing and more people getting out here. I actually might want to start doing lessons, like giving people lessons.
Good
because
for you.
A lot of people say I'm good enough to teach. I don't think so myself, but
I was really impressed.
No, maybe I will. I've already taught a few people who aren't even on blades how to skate a little bit better.
Mm-hmm.
So I might actually start doing that.
Great. Well, I definitely want to get some footage of you skating. I'm glad you're out enjoying.
Yeah.
And thank you for taking the time.
Of course.
Thank you.
I'm out to skate at Central Park every Saturday at 4 p.m.
If age is just a number and laughter is the best medicine, then we need to introduce you to this guy. At 81 years of age, Marty Ross is living his best life as a stand-up comedian.
Now, he decided to take his life experience and sense of humour to the stage in his late 60s, and he hasn't looked back, showcasing his best material with as many people as possible. He's even laughed all the way to the America's Got Talent stage.
When I get old, is that young people hate old people?
Oh,
is that right?
No.
Really? Did you ever drive behind an old person?
Yes.
Does this look familiar?
Yes.
That's great. Marty Ross joins us live from LA now. Hi, Marty. Welcome to the show. You were a salesman in the clothing industry, then you moved into stand-up comedy. What lured you to that stage?